and good day to you, everybody. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. We are playing Glover today, as we do every other day, pretty much. And today is quite the nice day. It's a little bit foggy, as you can clearly tell, but it's a lot more happier these days around Glover Town Land Pants. So that is because we have completed all of the worlds in the game except for the last world in the game. And wait for this. The greatest music in the entire game. I love the music in this first world. It's awesome. Or this first level. I think the music changes throughout each stage, but I don't know. So welcome to Spaceland Town. I believe this world is called Out of This World, ironically. And it is out of this world. We also have low gravity. And I will probably be complaining about the low gravity the entirety of this level, of this world even, because every single level in this has low gravity. It's kind of dumb, because the game itself is hard enough to control as it is without altering all of the physics. The physics that you come to learn throughout the entire game completely change in this level. I mean, and that's fine and everything, but I don't know. It annoys the crap out of me, so I would never make a game design choice like that. Or at the very least, not a poor game design choice like that. I just think that if the game is going to be altered like that, it should be done well. The controls should never frustrate the player. What should frustrate the player is the difficulty of the game. And if the difficulty is like artificially made by changing the, like, altering the controls, I just don't agree with that, I don't think. The only thing in this room is that life. But, you know, it's worth getting lives, especially since we're getting so close to the final boss, which we shouldn't have a problem with, and you will see why when we get there. The final boss is actually fairly easy, but it's cool, so I'm looking forward to fighting the final boss, honestly. And there's not a lot of games that I can actually honestly say that for. I think Banjo-Kazooie is probably the only other game that I really look forward to the final boss when I play it. Maybe Mario 64, but that's kind of along the same lines as Banjo-Kazooie. Let's be completely honest with ourselves here. And because of the low gravity, it actually makes it a lot more difficult to kill some of these enemies, too. And also a random Garib hidden behind this sign here. It makes it a lot more difficult to kill these enemies, because you have to kind of time your jumps differently. You have to time everything differently. It's dumb. I don't know. I'm going to be complaining a lot about that, so get used to it. Also, this is like, they're really bad positioning here. This whole level is really just not that great. I will still say, though, that the level that gives me the most trouble is probably the pirate level. To be completely honest with you, I fall off of that level so much and die so much compared to the other ones. Even the technically hardest one, the castle level where we fought Frankenstein, even that level is easier than the pirate level. But I'd say this level's pretty easy. It's just long. So where the hell is my ball? What have you done, Glover? What have you done with your ball? Seriously, where the hell is it? Oh, it, like, blended in with the... okay, fine. Fine. Fair enough. You win, sir. Oh, God. And now I have to try and... fly around. Luckily, if you have the ball, you don't have to worry about fall damage, which is a big problem with this level as well, is because of the high gravity, you're often way, way up in the sky. And then stupid stuff like this happens where Glover is off the screen and he has the... I am just going to complain the entire time. I have a right to complain at this crappy level. Oh, I'm frozen in time. I'm frozen in time and yet that platform still decides to move. So apparently the platform is like, it defies time itself. Actually, I don't need to bring this ball up here. Can I slap the ball over there? It's gonna fly right off the edge. Just wait and watch. Yup! I knew it! I knew it! I called that one. It's just funny, because we are... Oh, God. We are about as far into this episode as we were in the last episode when we completed the first one, and I don't even have half the Garibs. And I've just fallen off. No, ball, where are you going? I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch this... Fall and die. See what I mean by fall damage? It acts as though you're falling off of a cliff whenever you fall from, like, a high distance here, if you don't have the ball. But, of course, if your ball, like, flies away, anyway. Luckily, we have the checkpoint anyway, so that's all that we needed. Actually, I should have teleported back to the checkpoint. That would have been the easiest way to get back up there. No. Oh, God. Thank you, Glover, for being a hand and able to grab things. Let's get up here. We don't need to bring the ball up here, thank God. If this was a ball switch, I would have had to punch somebody's baby in the face. Not that I do that regularly, but I do. I punch babies. Don't bring your baby near me. And I guess that raises the platform in the green goop. What is that green goop? This is actually, the whole level is very stereotypical, like, cartoon space level. Like Duck Dodgers or the Jetsons. Just overall, the design of this level is really cartoony. I like it. The whole design of the whole game is very cartoony. For a good reason, but I don't know. I really like the design of this level. Even though the level itself kind of sucks, I kind of like the design of the levels. And I like that they're very stereotypical. As weird as that sounds, because usually stereotypical things are like, oh, it's the same old, same old. No, it's they're very stereotypical cartoony levels. But they really fit the game very well. I feel like I'm missing something. Let me just make sure I'm not missing any. I am missing Garibs. But where? Where am I missing Garibs? Oh, actually, that might just be pointing... I know. It's weird. The part of the level where the next Garibs are, we actually teleport to. And they must physically be in space. You know, in the video game space behind that wall over there. Because the Garib locator will... Oh my god! The Garib locator will point towards the wall. It's not even actually, like, water. It's like a hard surface. That's weird. I think I pushed the button. Did I push the button? It didn't show the cutscene where the ship comes. But there is a ship! Oh yeah, there it is. There's supposed to be a cutscene. But, I guess because I fell off and died, it didn't show the ship appearing. Which is sad, because the ship is kind of cool. I had a weird obsession with UFOs when I was a kid. Which reminds me of a movie I used to watch when I was really young. The Cat from Outer Space. Have you ever heard of The Cat from Outer Space? It was a ridiculous movie. It was about a cat. Well, okay, it was about a cat from outer space. That's kind of a given. But he had, like, this collar that made him talk, and his ship was, like, he crash-landed on Earth, and the only thing that could power his ship was a bar of gold. So this human guy that he comes across in his adventures helps him win some gold so that he could power his ship and fly home. And I'm pretty sure the cat had psychic powers. I don't know. I love that movie. I watched it a whole bunch. I love that movie. I haven't seen it in a very long time. I need to look that up. Man, The Cat from Outer Space. Oh, that's going to be my favorite movie of all time. Yay, there's the end of the level right there, but we still need 10 more Garibs, so we're not finished yet, sir. Yeah, see, they don't appear until after you come back. That's weird. I don't know why they would do that, but whatever. I'm not complaining. At least they did appear and didn't glitch out on me. I've had that happen before, where the game glitches out on me. Not this game in particular, but just games in general. Game-breaking glitches. I am not a fan of game-breaking glitches. And a number of games that I love the most have game-breaking glitches. Games like Twilight Princess has a game-breaking glitch. Banjo-Kazooie Xbox Live Arcade version sort of has a game-breaking glitch. Link's Awakening has a game-breaking glitch. It's just, yeah, I don't even know, man. They should really check that more often. Although games like this, old games, you can't, there's not, you know, they don't have the ability to update them like they do with today's games, so. It's kind of hit or miss. Actually, that's a complaint I have about today's games, is that they're a lot more buggy when they first release, because they are able to rush it out and then fix it later, which is just a poor, poor excuse. So there's a ball switch here at the beginning of this level that actually opens the door at the end of the level, but it's on a timer, so you have to go through the entire level and collect everything first, and then go back to the beginning of the level and push that button and run to the end before the timer runs out. Good luck! And, yeah, so we're not even going to worry about that right now. Just put it out of your mind. Be at peace with the button. Make friends with the button. If you don't push it, it won't push you. Yeah. I like this level. I like the whole canyon feel to it, where it's one long canyon. That's basically what it is, because, yeah, then you race the timer through the canyon. Is there something up here? This always stumped me. I always wondered why there was this speed boost here. There's actually a hidden panel right there that I just jumped on. That opens the... Oh, no! 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 All right. See, there's the panel right there, and that actually opens this wall here. And I didn't know that before. So there's a number of... Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I couldn't see a damn thing. This time with... Oh, God. Falling. This time with falling. Are you ready to rumble? I think I hit the panel. I hope I hit the panel. I did. I hit the panel. Just as long as I can get in here and... Oh, God. Stop. I need to wait for the speed booster to run out before I attempt this long, narrow passageway here. Good lord. All right. Oh, wow. And there's a bunch of Garibs over here. Hey there, guy. That sound effect sounds really familiar. But I can't quite put my finger on it. Oh, well. Goodbye, Mr. Purple. I will miss thee. He's purple, right? Why is the door closed? Open sesame! Open sesame. Glover just needs to place his hand on it. I imagine Glover just places his hand on the door and he starts to glow. I don't know why, but that's, I mean, he is a hand. So he places his, he caresses the door with his body and begins to glow. And then the door opens at his magical powers. He does have magical powers, so he could technically open a door that way, I think. Among other grand feats that he can perform, he could probably perform miracles, really. I mean, he's essentially the miracle worker of this world, right? Because he's the hand of a wizard. And they actually surprisingly do very, very little with that. The fact that Glover is a hand. Because they just sort of do early on with the whole being able to grab the sword thing, but they don't really do that anymore. Not really. There's one more place in this game that I can think of that it really... He becomes a hand, essentially, instead of just a character that looks like a hand. I don't know. I like the idea that he has magical powers. I feel like it hasn't been used as much as I thought that they were going to be using it, especially with the potions around. It doesn't get used nearly as much as I would have liked, I think. And I don't know if I mentioned this back when I mentioned the sequel, but the demo of the sequel that was released had Glover changing into a boxing glove. I think it would have been cool to expound on that in this game, too, where he transforms into different gloves as well as transforming his ball. I am making surprisingly good time with this level. The problem I had last time was that I didn't know that secret passage was there. And now that I know it's there, this whole level is quite a bit easier. There's only one... Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Don't lose the ball. Don't lose the ball. Now, this is mildly annoying. These guys... Oh, God. Don't pop my ball, please. If they touch your ball, it's going to go flying everywhere. That's the other thing about the gravity, too, is that when your ball pops, it really, really flies. I mean, it flies anyway in the other levels, but when you have a level like this... Oh, God. Also, this level in particular changes your mechanics as well. The blue strip here makes you slide. It makes you go faster and slide. And I never quite understood why, other than the fact that it's like supposed to be a speedrun level or something. So let's go back to the first checkpoint, because now that we have all the Garibs, we can push this button and race through the entire level. These guys respawned when I died, though, so that's sad. I was definitely on the button. Am I not heavy enough to push it? Do I need Ruto? Do I need to grab Ruto and have her on the button too? No, that's Ocarina of Time. All right. Oh, God. Don't let him touch you. And then this spiky smasher. Oh, thank God. That opened, like, perfectly in time. Oh, no! No! No, I'm going to have to restart. I'm going to have to restart. Ball, you don't fall down there. I'd rather not lose any life. I'd rather respawn and try again and then lose life. Oh, my goodness. Push. Push, please. Thank you. All right, let's do this. We can do this time. Speed run! Oh, God, I'm going to get hit. I almost did. Oh, I'm gonna get hit here. Oh god. It's like insanely close. No, every time. If I go, oh come on, I can still make it. I can still make it. I need to get a running speed though. Or get crushed. Figures this would be the part of the level that I have trouble with. It's the easy part. Not the run around and collecting shit. I guess I just have more experience running around collecting shit than I do doing speed runs. I'm really not good at speed runs. Like, even if I'm really, really good at a level, the second I have a goal to do it in a certain amount of time, it frigs with my mind. It really does. Okay, I need to go through the middle. So I'm going to wait for this one and then go, 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 and not let it smash me. Come on. I can make it. I can make it. Yeah, just as it starts closing. It's like an action movie starring Glover. Kevin Bacon as Glover. All right, anyway, that is it for this episode of Let's Play Glover. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. No, Ball, where are you going?
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch this fall and die.